this is John Cooler with GrownYourGreens.com, and today I'm on another field trip. I love traveling. Traveling is one of my biggest passions after, you know, growing my own food. And so we're here in Puerto Rico in the United States. So it's Puerto Rico, and it's a territory of the United States. No passports required to come here. We're actually at the Ann Wigmore Institute. And what I'm showing you today is their greenhouse, and I want to show you their raised beds. So the first thing that they're growing here, you may have saw this on one of my videos, because I grew this in the summertime, but here it is in January, and in Puerto Rico, it's, you know, a tropical climate year round. This guy does really well. I've never seen it literally vine out this much, and it just creeps everywhere. And this is called vine spinach or Malabar spinach, and there's two varieties. This happens to be the green variety. It's quite tasty, and I also grew the red variety at home, so you may have saw that during the summer months. I actually have some still growing in hydroponics inside my house, and I think I have some in the greenhouse. So they are definitely frost tender. They're not gonna make it in a northern climate, but here in the tropics, no problem, and they're oh so delicious. So I wanted to show you here, they have the raised beds, and basically for their raised beds, all they use literally is stones and rocks. And so here it is, their raised bed is literally basically out of stones, and they just make nice squares all the way down. And these are probably locally available rocks, possibly even from the beach down the street. And here's their new planting here. Looks like they're doing, you know, they're putting good compost down. We'll show their compost system in a minute. They have, you know, thermometers and tubes to basically dissipate the heat, because here in Puerto Rico it gets too hot. So you actually, the compost gets too hot, so they need to cool it down. They have a really unique system to do that. So here's their fresh plantings here, growing all kinds of stuff in the dark, rich, black compost. It looks like they're doing mostly the, you know, a square foot kind of system with things kind of more closely planted. I see some chard over in this bed, and these beds are a little bit higher than those other ones. So, you know, on these beds, what they used was basically rocks and some mortar to stick the rocks together, and they built it up high. And it's definitely doing good at, you know, holding all the soil in. A nice rustic look there. So the next bed over here, they have collard greens, and down over here they even have some parsley. Well, this, I wish I had a bed of parsley. This is one of my goals, to have a nice big bed of parsley like this, and I will one day. Oh man, and this one is really cool over here. Let's check this out. This is one of my favorite greens, and I'm growing it, but not quite yet. And I had another show that you saw me picking out culantro plants. So this is culantro. And man, I've never seen culantro leaves this big. It literally looks like a dandelion, but if you look, they have really sharp points. And I mean, if you get these right, they'll actually prick you. But this culantro tastes like cilantro. And it's a tropical. I'm actually growing some right now in January in my greenhouse in California, but my leaves aren't nearly this big, and this is the biggest I've ever seen leaves. And this is definitely, that rich cilantro taste. This is so delicious. If you live in the tropics or anywhere, you should definitely be growing this. So good. Yeah, and you can start it from seed. It may be hard to get them started. I got them by Starks. And if you live in Puerto Rico, the Starks were only 99 cents at a local nursery I saw. So let's move on. They have a lot of different raised beds. They have a couple. They have three low raised beds and 1, 2, 3, 4 high raised beds, and then another. Oh, let's check out this last raised bed. It's really interesting. So they're growing all kinds of different greens here. Oh, even dino kale. So this last bed, you know, this is what you could do with cinder blocks. Say you don't have rocks in your local area. All you have available is cinder blocks, or maybe on Craigslist, somebody is giving away cinder blocks. Well, take a look at what they're doing here. They're using the cinder blocks as their edging for their raised bed. So literally you just stack the cinder blocks up. Actually, they have it mortared in together, and then you fill it with dirt. And I'd even go a little bit further. These cinder blocks have spaces in here, and I'd even fill this with dirt and, you know, maybe plant some herbs. Like something like mint would be good to just plant in this, so then the mint couldn't spread, but it would grow out, and you'd have basically an edible edging as well. And here's their last thing, what they're doing, they have a raised bed, and then actually growing in containers. So maybe they need to keep this more moist or more hot for some reason. But look at this beautiful basil they have, you know, all relatively planted fairly close together. It's really looking vibrant and doing quite well. This This one, I think, is stevia. So, wow, this is amazing. They're growing fresh stevia here. Yep, that's stevia. Nice and sweet. And in the tropics, it grows year-round, no problem. Oh, this one is one that's been on my list to start growing one of these days. This is Cuban oregano. And Cuban oregano, it has a nice, unique flavor, and these leaves are nice and really thick. But definitely, that's definitely a tropics-only plant. All right, so this is the composting system they have here at the Ann Wigmore. This is all within the greenhouse. As you can see, they're composting their brown paper towels and different, you know, sprouted quinoas and everything. I mean, wheatgrass trays. I mean, the wheatgrass flats, basically the cut wheatgrass makes the border of the compost here. And you'll notice they have a PVC tube that has holes in it. And what that is in there for is to basically, the compost pile gets so hot, it needs to get some ventilation and let some of that heat out. Otherwise it would get too hot and cook the compost too much. So this is the first stage, raw produce and goes on this pile. Then once it gets composted a little bit, we'll move over to the next pile. They'll actually take this compost and move it over to the next stack. And this next stack definitely looks more like real compost. And you can see they have a thermometer in here. So, you know, they could put more of the white pipes to cool it down a little bit if it's not hot enough. I mean, if it's too hot. So it looks like the compost is sitting at about 110 degrees in the core of the compost. That's pretty warm. That's amazing. So as we go down here, they keep moving the compost down as it gets more ready. This is almost, you know, getting more ready. And as we go down here to the end, man, this compost looks amazing. I wish I could take some of this stuff home with me and use it in my garden. And this is actually what they're planting in here in their garden. As you saw the fresh starts, you saw the dark, rich, black compost. And the one thing I hope is I hope they're using rock dust here at the Ann Wigmore Institute, because that'll make all the produce taste much better and remineralize the soil, and that's really needed. So besides compost, remineralization is the key. You can learn more at remineralize.org. So this is John Kohler, and I hope you've learned a little bit here at the Ann Wigmore Institute at the garden here, or their inside their greenhouse with their raised bed gardens. So we'll see you next time.